Hello there, welcome back to Saska channel. Very quickly, we are going to change the light bulbs of our 4C Max 2011 is the brake bulb. Hopefully we'll get it done easy and you'll learn something as I learn something as I go. All right guys, so let's go for it. Just a quick tip, just for your comfort, to be able to replace the bulb and to unscrew those bulb eye, those knobs that we just seen, best thing is to take the trays of the car out, because otherwise they will keep hitting your shoulders and your head and your hands, and it's pretty uncomfortable. So as I said, I recommend you to remove those trays first. All right, okay my dears. All right, so what we're gonna do is open this door, or it's not difficult, but you have to be careful because it's placed properly. So here, just put a little bit and just take it out, okay? And then you can see the inside. You see the seat belt, and you can see in here you'll see two knobs. One here, you can see the other one, and you see another one there too. And then you see the connector. So the thing you have to do is unscrew those two things. All right, so let's see if we can do that. Now to remove those knobs, I also recommend you to move the seat belt away a little bit, just hitting the belt below, underneath this piece of cloth or whatever it is in there, so it's not in the way. Actually, these knobs are not very hard to remove, because as you can see, they're butterflies. They have two leverages here, two ears that you can actually grab and unscrew. So let's go do the first one, see if we can do that. Okay, see, it's not that hard. Just be careful. Okay, try not to drop it. So the first one is removed. Now the second one, we're gonna remove the second one. See, it's not that hard. Just you'll hear a little click, and that's it. And just be careful you don't drop it. There you go. So, according to the instructions of the manual, this is the first thing to do. So, the connector I will remove when I extract the light system out. Okay? All right. Okay, my dear, so here I'm wearing my mask and see if we can remove this thing. Never done it before, so it might take a while. All right, according to this, just start to see, taking those knobs out and shaking now. So I guess just grab it from here. Let's see. There you go. Okay. Alright, so now it's been taken off. Alright my friends, this is the lighting system, or the lighting, yeah, the lighting system taken out. We just extracted as we just seen. And as you can see, these are the two screws for the, that goes in here, one and two, that are holding the light system into the car. And then you have two plastic knobs, or leverages, or sticks, one and two, and they go one in here and the other one goes here in the on the top, at the bottom, see? So everything is held in place. All right, so now we're gonna remove this connector. All right guys, as you can see, this connector has a special pin in here. This is the one, let me see. If I can show you to you properly. Okay, it has a pin here. See, this is already taking it out because it's quite difficult to take out. But as long as you when you're pulling the connector out, or you're pulling the connector up, at the same time you have with the screwdriver, you have to push this in, because it has a clip, you can see. It has a clip here that holds the connector in place in here. So if you push this in hard and pull the connector out, you will take the pin out. You will take, it will retract the pin, and so you will be able to take the connector out. Okay, so we already done that, and the only thing you have to do is disconnect this, and be careful because the light system will come out. So let me hold the light system and take the connector out. There you go. And as you can see, now you got the entire assembly out and ready to disconnect. Yeah, change the bulbs. All right, dear. So the next step is to extract the bulb container or the bulb holder where the bulbs are connected, okay, which is this assembly here. Okay, to do that, you're gonna see three butterfly connectors, or if you want to call it butterfly, this is here. This one connector here, you can see, this one here, all right? And then you see two more here in the back here. One, two, and three. So you have to remove those three and extract the thing. So the best thing is to take this one out, the one that is alone, okay? Okay, now see, as you can see, it's out. And then try to lift a little bit. See, now it becomes loose. See, you can see it's loose. Now you extract those two carefully. You don't break them. One and two. There you go. And then just keep pushing up. So sometimes it's this part here. The second one here is a little hard. So it's a little tricky. You just have to be patient. Keep pulling out. Okay. Hopefully you haven't broken it. This one here. There you go. Now it's out. You will see. Now be careful. Always remember how you remove the thing. So just remove. As you can see, there's two bulbs. And this is the bulb container or the bulb holder. Bulb holder. Alright, so we're just gonna replace the bulbs now. Alright? Alright. So according to the manual, the bulbs that you're going to need are P21 5W. 5 watts, P21. All right, so what I'm going to do here, as you can see, there are two bulbs in here. The way you're going to do this is, it doesn't matter if you touch the bulb with your hands, because these ones are not, they don't get too hot, so there's no danger in it. So the thing you're going to do is push it downwards, and this is like a little spring underneath it. So you push it downward and turn it anti-clockwise, and yes, you remove it, and the bulb is out. Okay, so this bulb, the damaged one, just put it aside and take the right one. See if I can actually do it for you guys. Goodness, always have trouble when you do these things. Okay, now you have the right one, the good bulb, hopefully, and then you do the same procedure. Just put it in these two little holes in here, there. So these two, you see these two knobs, they fit in those two holes. Push it downwards, and oops, I think this is the wrong bulb. No, there you go. It's only one way you can go, actually. See, one is higher than the other one. So the higher one goes on the left side, and the lower one goes on the right side. So just put it in there, push it downward, and turn it clockwise, and then the bulb is secure. So the thing is now there. Hopefully it works. So we're gonna set it up and put it together and see if it works. All right, so let's put everything back together. You got the bulb assembly, so we're gonna put it the same way it was. The blinker light to the right and the braking light to the left. So there's only one way you can go, so just be careful. Make sure, see, everything goes fine. There you go, click in there. There you go, click in there, and clicking here, and we're done. Okay, okay, my dears, so we just gonna place the connector back into the assembly. The light assembly is very easy, so just make sure you hold it properly. You take the connector and you introduce it slowly and make sure you hear a click, right? You see? There you go, click. And then make sure, you know, it's not pulled away, all right? Okay, great. So this is, make sure, be careful with it. And it is there. And let's put the light assembly where it belongs. So let's check the light bulb before we place the harness, not the harness, but the light system, the assembly, back together. At the moment, the light here is only the position light, the normal lighting system. I haven't pressed brakes. And the other thing we're gonna check is the computer, all right? All right, so this is the computer. And when I had the braking light damage, it came out an alarm saying that the rear braking light was damaged. So we're gonna check the computer. We're gonna press the computer buttons here. Let's access the computer. Let's press over here to the left. And it says, well, it's in Spanish, it says onboard computer, then settings, adjustment, sorry. And then system control. So if you press system control or the right arrow, it tells me that the lights, the front lights, they are damaged. I have to actually replace that, the bulb in there, the front light is, we'll have to replace it. I have another video to do that. Okay, hold on, let me see. And let's see if the braking arrow, the broken braking light is there. It says that the light, the door conductor or the driving door is open, and then the hood, door is open as well. So, but it doesn't say that I have the braking light bulb damage. So it's fixed. Okay, so this is the tool case. And we're gonna place it all over the braking light, over the braking pedal there. Yeah, make sure it's there, secure. So we're gonna see if the light, if the braking lights came out, all right? Okay, so as you can see, the braking lights are on there. As you can see, are brighter. All right, so this one is working, and the right one and the left one also is also working. Let's bring the trunk door down, and as you can see, the trunk door braking lights are also on. So I have all the lights working. Yeah, right now it's time to place the assembly back. As you can see here, the two screws will go into these two places, and the plastic knobs that we just I showed you before, this one here, one and two, they're gonna go here underneath, and the other one over here. So hopefully it will not take too long. Be careful with the wire, you won't see me doing this probably, because it's a little there. Yeah. Okay, all right, it seems like everything went okay. So now it's time to place the knobs.
There you go, you can see the connector, and then you have the two screws there that we need to screw with our connector here, whatever you want to call it, the tap. Let's see if we can actually do it. Let's place this one here. Okay, careful we don't drop it. All right, it's pretty, it's one in there, so we grab the other one. There you go, and we're gonna place it on the other side. See if I can show you. All right, see. Pretty uncomfortable sometimes, these things. It's quite tight. There you go. And the other one as well is tight. Don't tighten it too much. and see what's gonna happen now. All right, and it's pretty secure, it's not moving. All right, so let's press or install the cover. That's the easy part. Just make sure it goes fine. Here I have to bend it a little bit, and then ready to go. All right, my friends and dears at Saska Channel. So we changed the rear braking bulb of a Ford C Max 2011. They told me that when one fails, probably the other one is about to fail. So we will change the one in the left side. I'll show you that in the video as well. Hopefully you have enjoyed the video as much as I have enjoyed it making it. I learned a lot from it, and hopefully you learn from it. And if I can do it, you can do it. So don't be afraid of spending some time changing that bulb for your wife's car or your brother's car or your own car. It's worthwhile, and you'll save a lot of money. All right, guys, see you later.